In this video, what I do is go over the Maxon updates for the month of February. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, so let's dive into what's new in the February updates of Cinema 4D and Redshift. And this will be for versions 2024.3 and Redshift 3.5.240. And I think by far the biggest one is, at least for Cinema 4D and Redshift users, is going to be that M3 chips, the Apple M3 chips, now have ray tracing support. And what that means is, if you go into your Redshift settings on an M3 computer, really any Apple computer, you should now have this checkbox that enables you to turn on hardware ray tracing on and off. And what's nice about that is, even if you're on an M1 or M2 chip that doesn't have ray tracing support, you could still turn this on. And if you end up rendering later on a render farm that does have hardware ray tracing, you should see improvements on your render time. So that's something I do think is pretty nice, and that might benefit more people than, initially you're just going to benefit from the M3 itself. Okay. Redshift wise, it doesn't seem like there's a whole lot more going on. They talk about improved interpolation in the ramp node lines in a stepped gradient. So I guess that's kind of nice. They added some capsules for Adobe Substance 3D. We'll go over and take a look at a few of those. They updated or improved export capability for GLTF and USD. And I believe this is the format that After Effects uses for its 3D models. And so perhaps, this could be something that benefits people who do a lot of that type of thing. I've looked into that, haven't found it terribly interesting myself or worthwhile, but who knows? Maybe at some point it will become better. And they also apparently made some improvements to the asset browser animated previews. If you have a lot of things that are animated in there, like maybe character animations like they're showing. So that seems really interesting. The capsules, though, I think are the big selling point. And honestly, much as I would like to see more things added, whether it's materials, whether it's models, they do seem to be doing a pretty good job. I think the biggest thing not too long ago they added was a bunch of studio HDRIs, or just HDRIs in general, which I thought was really, really nice. Obviously, there are free places like Polyhaven and HDRI Haven, that part of the site where you can find several as well. But, anytime I can save by going to the asset browser, that's going to make things a little bit quicker. And I guess there's some Cineware updates as well. But what I wanted to focus on was the capsule stuff, the substance materials. They say they reworked a lot of the asset browser. I don't see too much evidence of that. I'm sure this new capsule section has been around for a while. I also like that it shows the category here. These are all the substance materials we now have. 40 more Redshift materials ready to go. You can also find them if you go to the materials section in Substance 3D, right? It's kind of telling you that actually when you are right here, kind of what category it's in, which is kind of nice. Makes it a little bit easier to find these things. Now, one of the things I wanted to double check here is by throwing a couple of these on to some cubes is to see what these look like right away. Okay, and while they don't look bad, they definitely leave a little bit to be desired. And so when we open up our material manager and node editor here, it is using kind of the new substance import, which I do think is nice. I haven't used it a whole bunch. And what I find really interesting about it is that you don't have a way to solo individual maps. Right? That's something I use quite a bit, especially if it's like a bump map or a normal. I guess you do have, those you could solo, right? But for instance, this acoustic foam, it's quite difficult to see the pattern here. And so soloing a bump map or a normal map can sometimes make that a little bit easier, right? Even the displacement doesn't look like it has too much going on. I've thought about making a video about this, but it is pretty straightforward, so I really didn't see the point there. What I do want to do, though, is go through and set up a Redshift object tag on these so we can see what they look like. Because while they look pretty good now, right, zoom in pretty close, they hold up pretty well, we're pretty close there, so I'll give it the benefit of the doubt. I wish that was maybe a bit brighter. Let's see what they look like with displacement. So I'll come in here to the geometry section. I'll turn on tessellation. I also need to turn on displacement. And you'll notice some of these get a bit distorted here. And that's because I need to uncheck smooth subdivision. With that on, it's almost like it's being put in a subdivision surface deformer, which, you know, changes the shape. And for, you know, with these, it was actually warping the UVs, which we don't need. To finish this, we'll increase the maximum displacement and displacement scale. And now we'll start to see some displacement. I don't think each one necessarily needs this much displacement. Like, for instance, the brick is having a bit of a problem. I will say, though, you know, there is a fillet on these cubes, and I'm not sure that's really going to benefit this with displacement. So let's turn that off, and we'll probably get something a little bit more even. All right, so the brick one looks pretty good, like we are seeing. I like how you can see the corner there. Maybe need a few more, a little bit more detail in there, and I probably would just do that in the object itself, maybe just by setting these to like 10 in each direction. Might be enough to kind of smooth those out, and that seems to have helped a bit. So happy with that. The foam, I mean, you can definitely see it more now. I still think I'd probably want it a little bit brighter. I suppose it could be the lighting, but I doubt, you know, that is the only thing. So I wonder if we just came in here with like a ramp, dropped it on the base color property, and then brought up the brightness a little. So that's it. Oh, did I start finally starting to do something? No, just a little bit of, oh, there we go. Okay. So really, really dark. Still not quite where I would like it, but you know, once again, dependent on your scene lighting, I suppose. That's looking pretty good and really nice, you know, kind of clean displacement from what I'm seeing there. The carrot skin probably, you know, should be on a longer object, right? When you think about a carrot, longer and narrow. So I wonder if maybe something like that wouldn't, work a little bit better. But from a displacement point of view, you know, we are seeing the silhouette here change quite a bit. And that's the best place to, you know, see changes in displacement. It's very obvious on the brick as well as the acoustic foam. And that's just a few of these. It looks like there's quite a few nice substance here. And if nothing else, it's just kind of a nice way to see how a substance is set up and reverse engineer it if you do want to use a substance that you find online or in Adobe Substance 3D. But I think that's really going to do it. So that will do it for this one. If there's anything else you would like to see, please let me know. And until next time, take care.